It's time that we stop our horses from rushing on the trail, and let's do it in just two simple steps. Let's roll the intro and get started. So we've all been there, right? We've been on this trail ride where our horse wants to jig the entire time, side pass the entire time, wants to be in the lead. Even when they're in the lead, they don't want to be in the lead anymore. They want to be behind. It's literally just a terrible experience overall. So we have to ask ourselves, how can we fix this problem? So today we're going to talk about just two simple steps of fixing how to stop rushing on the trail. Before I get started, the first thing you have to understand is there's a multitude of ways to really help with things. What I'm going to give you today is one of the most effective, best ways to doing it with as little fight as possible from your horse. The first thing that you need to do is actually on the ground. It's something that you need to do before you ever get on. Teaching your horse this exercise from the ground is really going to be able to literally create its effectiveness and the success rate that you have when you're riding. What you need to do is teach our leading exercise from the ground. And what that is being able to get the horse to lead 3 to 5 feet behind you. And what you're looking for is to teach the horse that when you as the handler look back, ask the horse to get back away, that your horse actually responds in a positive way of getting back. Now, in order to do this, what you want to do is make sure that your body energy is in a ask then tell type of idea. So what you're really looking for is you ask the horse to get back, and if the horse doesn't listen to that ask, you're going to go ahead and tell the horse to get back. As soon as this happens, you're going to reward the horse by literally dropping all pressure, standing there and just relaxing. What you're going to notice is after a few times doing this, your horse is actually going to lower his head, relax, ears are going to gently rock back, and the horse is going to become a lot more responsive to you. But at the same time, if your energy is relaxed, they are going to become a lot more relaxed. Once you've done this a multitude of times, your horse is in a great state of mind, relaxed, paying attention to you, then it's time that we can practice this under saddle. So for step two, this is best done with a trail buddy that's going to be out there to really help you along the way. What this trail buddy needs to be able to do is know the exercise, know how to use it, because now this exercise is going to get transferred to the person riding the horse in front of you. What that means is while you're riding, you're going to steer your horse directly towards the horse's butt in front of you. When you're doing this, every time that your horse starts to creep up too close to your buddy, you're going to ask them to use the leading exercise on your horse. What this does is it takes away all the fight that actually happens when you ask the horse to stop jigging or stop rushing on the trail. It really just puts it in the hands of the person in front of you. And in fact, as soon as the horse starts to recognize that the horse in front, he can't pass, he'll start to calm down, relax, listen to the energy of what's provided in front, and he will automatically just start to relax and enjoy his actual ride. This process really only takes 5 to 10 minutes at most, but if done correctly, it's really going to do a nice job on teaching our horses how to go to that calm, relaxed state of mind without a fight. A key tip to remember when you're doing this is you really don't want to be the one fighting them, so all you really have to do is just use your hands as a guidance system right towards the butt in front. As soon as the horse comes up too close, the buddy is going to be the one telling him to get back, but you're just going to be giving him a loose rein. You don't want to pull on those reins and really start being the one who's fighting on your horse. So I recommend go give it a try. Do it in a safe environment first so your horse understands it, then take it out on the trail, and then I can guarantee you that every time that you're out there on the trail, if your horse starts to jig, you can use this exercise and be successful. If you like the tips and tricks that you're hearing on this channel, but you want to be able to have a program that helps you every step of the way, I recommend that you go check out our Leadership Club program. Otherwise, please feel free to click the subscribe button, the like button, and if you have any questions or suggestions of a video you'd like to see next, please feel free to comment in the section below. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.